Sue Baumgardt is an animal rights campaigner and a member of the Green Party Animal Protection Group. She was awarded a Community Heroes Award and is here to talk to me about animal welfare issues in Brighton and the area. Hello, Sue.
Hello.
Thank you for coming.
Pleasure.
You know, when we talk about Brighton, or when Brighton is mentioned, it's not really something that we associate with animal cruelty. We think about Brighton as a progressive, liberal place, full of vegetarians, vegans, a green MP. But obviously you're here to talk about the fact that things are not necessarily quite as rosy in terms of animal welfare.
That's right. I mean, the progressive bit is a bit of a veneer. Yes, there's lots of progressive things, but there's also the dark side of Brighton and Hove. We have a Greyhound stadium, a horse racing track. There's vivisection at the universities. So there are countless issues for people to get involved with.
Let's maybe start talking about hunting. It's the hunting season has just ended, and I rather innocently was sure that there was no hunting at all in this country because back in 2004 it was made illegal. But apparently not so, and not far from here, hunting is and has been going on. Is that right?
That's right. Since 2004, hunts have exploited every loophole they can find in the Act. They are allegedly trail hunting, something that was invented in 2004, where they say they're laying a false scent of a fox so that the hounds follow that. So they're still killing foxes,
still,
and they say it's an accident.
And you're a member of Hunting Saboteurs group. What do you actually do to try and disrupt this process?
We are there with cameras, so the fact that we're present makes the hunt wary because we can get evidence which can get them convicted. And in fact, we've done that on two, three occasions. We also spray the ground with citronella if we see a fox run across, because that way when the hounds come along on the tail of the fox, they lose the scent. It's completely harmless.
Citronella counters the scent of
the scent of the fox. It's completely harmless to the hounds.
Okay. And the hunters presumably are not too happy to see you?
They're never happy to see us because it stops their fun, which is killing.
And how can you perhaps make sure that it doesn't get too nasty between people? I mean, we obviously want to protect the animals, but we also don't want to cause too harm to people.
We try always to be within the law, and the only time we'll go what is theoretically against the law, which is trespass, as if we're directly out to save a life. But otherwise, no, we're not violent. We've experienced more violence from the hunt than they've ever experienced from us.
Okay, let's move on to talk about dogs, because Brighton, or Hove rather, have a Greyhound stadium. And I, again, maybe innocently, always thought that the Greyhounds are having fun. They're just running after what they think is a hare. That's what they're meant to do. They're racing horse. They're fast. They're fast. But that's not the case.
The problem is that dogs get injured on the track. Last week in Hove, Bonamassa Blues died while racing. We assume a heart attack, but the dog collapsed and died. This week, seven dogs have fallen at the racetrack. We don't know what's happened to them because the industry doesn't release the results of those falls.
So they keep it as a secret?
They keep it as a secret. No doubt somewhere someone can find out. But it's just what happens to the dogs. There are thousands bred. The latest figures show over 1,000 greyhounds were put down last year. They can't rehome them all. They say they rehome them. They can't rehome them all. The welfare centres are chock-a-block with ex-racers.
And so what do people in Brighton Hove do about that?
We're having demonstrations, ad hoc demonstrations, at the Greyhound Stadium. And we are peaceful. In fact, they're silent demonstrations where we just hold placards showing people what goes on in the racing industry. So they're very peaceful and very positive.
Okay. One final thing that you're involved with, and I think we'll probably ask you to come back later on in a few months when the project takes place, and that's what you got your award for, is for homing hens. Right, so maybe a very quick,
right,
quick word about homing hens.
Very quick. Okay, well, all laying hens go to slaughter at about 80 weeks because their laying declines and they're no longer commercial. They would come back into lay, but nobody can wait for that to happen.
And so you help by rehoming.
I
will ask
them.
You to come back.
Yeah.
And people can find out on Facebook or on the internet about how to
Rehome them. Yes, there's an organisation called Fresh Start for Hens, and they are doing the
The details on the screen.
Fine.
Thank you so much for coming.
It was a pleasure.
And we'll see you again.
Thank you.